Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Good morning, everybody. Today, we are going to talking about in Traveler 5, Module 3, Unit 5, Listening and Modal Verbs, page 62 and page 63. You will be able, inshallah, to practice listening and study British and American English and study modal verb. Let's go to this page, please. Let's go to this page, please. Page 62 and 63. And we will listen 8 dialogues, okay, between 2 persons. And after that, you have 3 pictures. In every lesson, you have 3 pictures, okay? Before you listen, I want to give you some tips for listening skill. The first thing, before you start listen, look at the 3 pictures. You have 3 pictures. Look at the 3 pictures carefully to get the general idea, to understand what is these 3 pictures talking about, of what are going to hear. Okay. Then listen carefully to the dialogue and focus on the question. Concentrate on the question. What is the question? Because in the dialogue, he will mention all the 3 pictures. Okay? You can see here, all 3 pictures may be referred to, in the dialogue, may be mentioned in the dialogue. Maybe they say the name of the all 3 pictures in the dialogue. So, however, only one of them correctly answer the question. Now, we are going to hear. Please concentrate on the picture, look at the picture, listen, and then listen to the question to give the answer, okay? Let's start.
It must have been fun growing up on a farm. It wasn't all fun and games. There was a lot of work to do.
Really? Like using a tractor to plow a field?
Actually, my dad always did that. I took care of the animals. I fed the chickens and cows.
What did the man's father do on the farm?
Okay, again. Here again, please.
It must have been fun growing up on a farm. It wasn't all fun and games. There was a lot of work to do.
Really? Like using a tractor to plow a field?
Actually, my dad always did that. I took care of the animals. I fed the chickens and cows.
What did the man's father do on the farm?
Father, what is his father doing the farm? He's a director, that's right? Okay, let's check the answer. Here, you can see the first man and second man transcript. He said, like using tractor to plow to make the land ready for plants, a field. Actually, my dad always did that. Okay. What did the man's father do on the farm? The answer will be B. Okay. It's easy, right? Okay, let's go to the second one.
I love going antique hunting on the weekends.
Me too. I've been collecting antiques for over 20 years.
Let me guess, you collect silver candlesticks?
No, antique furniture. Although lately, I've had my eye on this beautiful grandfather clock.
What is the man thinking of buying?
Okay. Listen again. Listen again. And please listen to the carefully to the question.
I love going antique hunting on the weekends.
Me too. I've been collecting antiques for over 20 years.
Let me guess, you collect silver candlesticks?
No, antique furniture. Although lately, I've had my eye on this beautiful grandfather clock.
What is the man thinking of buying?
What is the man thinking of buying? Let's look at the transcript. This is the conversation between them. Antique. I love going to antique hunting to buy some antiques like this. It's old furniture and expensive. Also has a high value on the weekend. Me too. Okay, let's go to the highlighted sentence. Lately, I have had my eye on the beautiful grandfather clock. Okay, so here, what is the man thinking of buying? He's thinking of buying a clock. Okay, let's go to number three.
So have you decided where you're going to move to, Peter?
Not yet, but I'd like to try the desert.
Are you crazy? What about somewhere in the mountains next to a big lake?
Maybe. I like the sound of that, actually.
I still don't know why you'd want to leave the city. Seattle is such a great place to live in.
Where does the boy live now?
Okay, again.
So, have you decided where you're going to move to, Peter?
Not yet, but I'd like to try the desert.
Are you crazy? What about somewhere in the mountains next to a big lake?
Maybe. I like the sound of that, actually.
I still don't know why you'd want to leave the city. Seattle is such a great place to live in.
Where does the boy live now?
Where does he live now? Desert, mountain, lake, or in Seattle? Let's look. Okay, I still don't know why you'd want to leave city. Seattle is such a great place. It's fine, Seattle. Seattle is a city in the United States. So the boy is in, live in Seattle. After that, number four.
How's the new job going?
Oh, same old thing, different day. If you work at one office, you've worked at them all.
I see. So you still spend most of your time in front of the computer, huh?
If I'm not there, I'm in meetings all day. At least I don't have to battle fax machines anymore.
What doesn't the man do at work?
What doesn't? Listen to this question. What doesn't? The question starts with the negative. So,
how's the new job going?
Oh, same old thing, different day. If you work at one office, you've worked at them all.
I see. So you still spend most of your time in front of the computer, huh?
If I'm not there, I'm in meetings all day. At least I don't have to battle fax machines anymore.
Okay.
What doesn't the man do at work?
What doesn't he do with work? Computer or meeting or battling with the facts? Battle, it's fighting with the facts. Try to make the facts work and fix it. Okay, at least I don't have to battle fax machine anymore. But look at the question. What doesn't the man do at work? He do this one, he do also this one, but he doesn't do what? Battle with the facts or battling with the facts. Let's go to the another slide. We have the last four dialogue. Listen, please.
Shoo, shoo, get out of here. Mom!
Why are you shouting, sis? Oh, come on. Don't tell me you're afraid of a little spider.
I'm terrified of him. And you shouldn't make fun of me, you that can't look at snakes.
That's not the same at all. Snakes are much scarier. Worse than rats, even.
What is the boy most afraid of?
Okay, the question about the boy, not the girl, okay?
Shoo, shoo! Get out of here! Mom!
Why are you shouting, sis? Oh, come on. Don't tell me you're afraid of a little spider.
I'm terrified of him. And you shouldn't make fun of me, you that can't look at snakes.
That's not the same at all. Snakes are much scarier. Worse than rats, even.
What is the boy most afraid of?
Okay, what's the boy most afraid of? Here, the dialogue, and he said that's not the same at all. Snakes are much scarier, worse than rats. This is the rats. Even this is the rats, okay? So the answer will be snake. Number six.
When did Lynn have her baby? The 15th?
No, I'm sure it was August 13th.
Oh, that's right. She said her baby was born the day before her own birthday.
Right, and I definitely know that hers is on the 14th. When was the baby born?
When was the baby born? 13th, 14th, 15th. Listen, they mention every three choices here, but the answer will be one only. When the boy born, 13th, 14th, 15th. Look at here, I am sure it was August 13th. So the answer will be A. Let's go number 7.
I love coming to this aquarium. I've never seen so many exotic fish and marine animals before. Tell me about it. My favorite was the jellyfish exhibit. Yeah, it's just too bad the shark exhibit was closed.
What didn't they see at the aquarium?
Also, the question here is negative. What didn't? Okay, what didn't?
I love coming to this aquarium. I've never seen so many exotic fish and marine animals before. Tell me about it. My favorite was the jellyfish exhibit. Yeah, it's just too bad the shark exhibit was closed.
What didn't they see at the aquarium?
Was closed. What is the closed exhibition here? Let's look at the transcript. Sorry. Yeah, it's just too bad the shark exhibit was closed. Here, what didn't negative they see at the aquarium? Aquarium is the place for to show or the exhibition to show the fish and other water animal. Okay, what didn't they see? They see everything, but what didn't they see? They didn't see shark. Last one, listen please.
Wait a minute, Sam. I'm confused. I thought your house is next to a restaurant.
It is, but it's a Mexican restaurant, not an Italian one.
Ah, and there's a bookstore on the other side of your house, right?
There used to be. Now there's a shoe store.
Where's Sam's house?
Where's Sam's house? He is between restaurant and bookstore. But bookstore changed to be what show store. Look at the transcript. Wait a minute, Sam, I'm confused. I thought your house is next to a restaurant. It's next to a restaurant. Okay, there is a restaurant in every picture here. It's a Mexican, not Italian. So we will eliminate A. And then there is bookstore on the other side of your house, right? Used to be. It was in the past. Now there is a shoe store, okay? Here, we can say C is the better answer, okay? Okay, guys, thank you for listening. And now, this is the transcript. If you want to take or capture the slide, this is the transcript for every question or every dialogue. Okay, then we are going to talking about British and American English. As you know, we have some words in English, nouns or other things can used in American, and they have another alternative words to use in Britain. And it's same if you use Britain or British language or American language, it's same, no problem. Let's take a look at this person. He talk about himself. He said, I work a lot during the week. That's why I love the weekends so much. On the weekend, look at the screen, please. On the weekend, in American language, we can say on the weekend, but in British language, at the weekend. I try to do little as possible. Sometimes I go downtown. In American, we can say downtown. But in with British language, you must say city center. And hang out with my friend. We usually grab a sandwich, eat a sandwich, that means, and fries. Fries, in American, we can say fries, but in Britain, at a local diner, local diner is a local restaurant, okay? In American, they say a local diner. In Britain, we can say cafeteria or restaurant. I prefer to stay at home and watch my favorites. There is a spelling here. The change is in a spelling. Check with me, favorite. There's U between O and R. In American, you can write it like this way. In Britain, you can write it like this way. And all of them are same, are correct. Program. In American, they write with one M, but in British language, they write with double M. Leaving my apartment, we can say apartment in America, and we can say flats. It's not appear here. Let me write it on the board, please. Flats, you can say, sorry, flat. Okay, this is flats. And let's go to the other person. Last week, I did the stupidest thing, the worst thing. I lost my cell phone. Cell phone in American language, in British language, mobile phone. It was nice day. I decided to walk home from work rather than take the subway. Subway in America, you can say underground in Britain. It's a train. It's a train come under the ground. I was almost home. I realize we can. There is a change in spelling here between American language and British language. Realize. It's same, but there is only the change only in the spelling. That my phone was gone. I went to gas station. Gas station in American language. We can say petrol station in English language. Pay the phone and call my cell phone. Also, as I said before here, it's mobile phone. I sometimes would answer. A man picked up the phone. He said he had found my phone on the sidewalk. Sidewalk. What's the sidewalk? It's the place for walking only. The place for walking only, and it's always come beside the street. Pavement. In Britain, they say pavement. In front of the local drugstore, pharmacy. You can say pharmacy in Britain or chemists in also Britain. Luck to me or for me, I guess anyway, I'm going to more careful more now on. Let's go to the another one, and please do that with individuals. And go, please, to the British and American English in spelling and words and phrases, grammar, usage, the appendix II. Okay, go to the appendix, and this is the appendix. You can see there is a lot of words used by British, and this is used by American, and it's same. Like biscuits in British, it's cookies in America. Like, for example, garden in British, it's yard in America, etc. Okay? Football in British, it is soccer in America. And also there is another slide of American and British English. And we have here change in spelling. Look at the center, R come before E in British, but here in American, R come after E. Etc. Okay? And also we have a grammar and usage. In British they say 28 February. They start with the day and then the month. But in American they start with the month every time and then they write the day. Also, there is another thing in grammar and usage. Okay, let's go to the modal verb. I will give you the brief about modal verb. And I know, I understand that you studied this lesson before. Okay, modal verb. It measures the ability, obligation, and necessity. Obligation, that's something you must to do. Permission, if you want to go anyone, you have to get a permit from your teacher or from your boss. So this is the permission, request and order, advice and opinion, if you want to give advice and opinion, prohibition, that must not done, and absence of obligation. Modal verb, it's like can, you can see, where is it? Yes, can, and must, need, had to, have to, could, might, would, etc., and had better. Let me give you the brief about ability. We can use, in present, we can use can, but in past, we must use what? We must use could. Let me take the examples from the first, sorry. Will you help me? This is request. Will you help me? He starts with will. This is request. You can start with may, can, could. Can you help me? May you help me? Could you help me? Etc. Number two, I am sorry, sir, but you can't smoke here. You can't. This is prohibition. So, prohibition, so he must not smoke here. I think you ought to apologize. So this is what? Sorry, yes, obligation or necessary. Apologize to your sister for your behavior. So he have to advise. This is advice, sorry. This is advice. Advice, have to. I could swim when I was 4 years old. This is could, because it was in the past. And I really have studied hard to my math exam. I really have to. I should do that. So, obligation. I have to. You don't have to shout. I am not deaf. Deaf, person who doesn't listen. You don't have shot, he's angry, so this is the absence of obligation. Excuse me, may I use, this is the permission. The most important thing here, look here, could express general ability in the past. General ability in the past was and were able to express ability in the particular situation in the past. This is used in the past. Might and may and could, it's formal, but can, it's not formal. You can use can with your friend, but might and may and could, you can use it with the formal situation. Go to grammar reference page 93 and 94. It's existed here, and there is tables to arrange the ideas and to arrange the modal verbs. Okay, also you can use with the informal and formal, polite. This is more polite than can and will. Okay, and this is also the example about had better and should. You can see the tables. It's examples for everyone, for everything. Okay, and this is the practice after you finish the lesson. Please answer the practice, please. And sorry for not giving more details because we have limited time. And see you, inshallah, tomorrow. Goodbye, guys.